Hello, my name is Kim, professor of Kalasangyan University, India. Today's topic is second lecture of discrete Fourier transform, DFT. Here, let me take one example of discrete Fourier transform and inverse discrete Fourier transform. From this, we can plot magnitude spectrum and the phase spectrum. Okay, let me review the formulas for a Fourier transform. First, continuous time Fourier transform. Continuous time Fourier transform means from this continuous time signal x of t to continuous frequency x of omega, we call it continuous time Fourier transform. And the discrete time Fourier transform means discrete signal to continuous frequency x of omega. We call this discrete time Fourier transform. And discrete Fourier transform means discrete signal and the frequency also discrete frequency. Therefore, discrete means discrete time and discrete frequency means. We call this discrete Fourier transform. And we can get discrete spectrum like the x of k. Also, here k equals 0, 2, and minus 1. And inverse discrete Fourier transform means from x of k, we can get x of n waveform. This. For this, we need this coefficient. Okay, let me take one example, x of n from x of 1. We get x over k, and from this we can get over x of n. Now, x of n equal 3, 2, minus 1, 0, 2. Now this under bar means n equal 0. This is equal 1, 2, 3, 4. Like this, therefore, frame length is 5. And here also, sampling frequency equal 100 Hz. Then first, time resolution means NTS equal NTS equal 2 seconds. Frequency resolution means FS by N is 100 by 5 equal 20 Hz. It's very easy. Next, X over K, that's we need to expand this formula. Okay, formula. Now here, the variable of summation is n, and this is the k variable, k equals 0, 1, 2, 3, 5. This is k, and n equal here, n, n equals 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Like this, we can get x of 0 equal 6. X1 equal k equal mean, like this here, k equal 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and n equal 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then from this we can get this result. This is a complex number. Like this, we can get x over 2, x over 3, and x over 4, like this. Then from this magnitude, this is a modulus of x of k. Now this modulus equals 6. And x of 1 modulus is 5.08. And the modulus of x of 2 is 1.10. Modulus of x of 3, 1.10. Modulus of x of 4, like this. We call this magnitude of x of k. Then, frequency of x over k. Now, I said, frequency resolution is 20 Hz. Therefore, x0 means 0 Hz. 1 means 20 Hz, 40 Hz, 60 Hz, 80 Hz, like this. Then now, pay attention to this one, 60 and 80. Is it correct? Yes, it's correct. It's a realistic one, otherwise not. Okay, from this, what we can know is from the sampling theorem, FS greater than two times of fmax. fmax means maximum frequency in signal. From this, maximum frequency is less than 50. Therefore, this is higher than 50, therefore this is not real one. This is the frequency component in signals. Next, okay. Next, invert Fourier transform. Invert means from x of k, we can know x of n by using this this formula. X of k, already we know this x of k. From this, we can know x of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 like this. And plot magnitude and phase spectrum. Now here, this input x of n equal 3, 2, minus 1, 0, 2. This is the reconstructed waveform from x of k. This also 3, 2, minus 1, 0. Do we call this same? And also magnitude spectrum with respect to frequency. Phase spectrum also with respect to the frequency of this. Okay, this is for the source for your reference. You know, sampling frequency. And this frequency resolution and DFT. In MATLAB, we are using FFT. This is DFT. And then magnitude means absolute. This means modulus. For phase angle, this inverse Dirichlet Fourier transform. This command IFFT or IFT. This is the for floating command. Thank you so much for your watching. Today, I have explained one example of a discrete Fourier transform. Here, time resolution, frequency resolution, magnitude and the phase spectrum, inverse discrete Fourier transform, and how to plot the spectrum are explained. Next topic is how to change to this N. Now in DFT here, it is the frame length N is a very important concept. For that, I will explain. This is the problem of window functions. Please look forward to next lecture. Thank you very much again.